Hello guys, this is Al from OpenLiteSpeed channel. Welcome for a new episode. Today we're going to talk about CyberPanel and we're going to show you how to install it with just one single line. Don't forget to like and subscribe, share the videos. The more you share, the more videos I can do. And don't forget to click on the bell icon so you get notified for new videos. So here we go, this is cyberpanel.net. Here you can find all the information in regards of this web hosting panel. It's very simple to install it. We're going to use just one line for it. Here also you can find on their community discussion board all the information, how to install it and everything you need under one roof. Right, there are multiple versions of CyberPanel. We're going to install the free one, the actual open source version, as you can see here. So let's go and get started. Don't forget, all the information will be in the description below. Here you can find all the requirements for the server. And here is the actual installation script that we're going to use. You can install it on CentOS 7, 8, Ubuntu, 18.04 and 20.04. 1 gig of RAM and at least 10 gig space on your hard drive. I'm going to use PuTTY. And the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to log in to my server. I'm using a local server because I couldn't do it. I wanted to use a different one, but I'm going to use my own home server to do this installation. Alright, so this is what we're going to use today, the actual installation script from their website. I do have some notes on, you know, myself here, but this is a different type of installation, so I just wanted to do it in an easier way, so I'm going to use the one on their website. I was also installing other things as well on the same server. This is what I done on my own server, really. This is not what the actual notes come from, but we're going to use the one on their website. It's very simple, one line, as you can see here, and that's what we're going to copy and paste. And that's all it is, copy and paste, and you need to answer a few questions that comes up in the installation, and then you got to wait. There is a lot of wait for the actual installation. It doesn't install. It depends also your web connection, how fast it is, all right? But technically, within half an hour, it should be everything done. It depends on the speed as well of your server. Alright, so I'm going to log in using PuTTY, my terminal here. I'm going to put my login details and I am inside. Now, usually the first thing you got to do is to update and upgrade your system. You want to make sure it's up to date before you do the installation. So you type sudo apt update and then the sudo apt upgrade. In this instance, I'm using Ubuntu, put my password in. And I'm going to press enter and that should be done in no time at all. Let's do upgrade and that's it. That's been done because it was already done previously, but you also might take a little bit longer. Now what I'm going to do is going to copy this part. Here we go, from the website, not from the right side, but one on the left. Again, you can see it also on the right now. I'm going to make a copy and I'm going to paste there. It might come out in an error here because I haven't done exactly. I haven't done it as a sudo, as a root. So I got to do sudo. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to, let me delete that a second. Let's see if I can do under sudo. I might need to write sudo su and dash. There we go. Let's do this. There we go. Now I'm going to paste it and I'm going with the installation. No, we shouldn't have any problem whatsoever. Make sure you're in root. Again, I'm going to press now 1 for install CyberPanel. Press enter. Then I'm going to install CyberPanel with OpenLiteSpeed. I'm not going to choose the second, it's the first option. So press 1 and press enter. Then I'm going to say full installation, yes. You can press enter or Y, it's up to you. I'm going to press Y. This one is no. You want to remote. You don't want MySQL remote. You just want to do it locally. I'm going to press enter for the latest. And I'm going to choose R as random. I want the actual system to come up with the random password for me. So that will be auto-generated and will be shown at the end of the installation. Do you wish to install the memcache? And I'm going to say yes. Yes as well for the watchdog and yes for the Redis above. And here we go. It's going to take time for, logically, I'm going to edit this down and it's going to take in no time, really. It should be done in a few seconds. There we go, we got information. This is where you can find all the information about the admin, the password. All I've done here, just blurred my IP, as this is a static IP and I didn't want anybody to know, just in case. I'm going to reboot the server here. Make sure you reboot it. I'm going to, as you can see here, I actually pasted in my notepad so I can actually easily get access. And I'm going to the browser. I'm going to put 192.168.1.1.5. You will get the outside IP. I just put my local IP rather than my public. So I'm going to put admin, and that's the password, as you can see there. I'm going to type it. You can choose your language. I'm going to choose English, and I'm going to press sign in. All right, so we are inside the actual panel. Again, I'm blurring some part of the panel. This is not a tutorial about the actual panel itself, how to use it, just how to install it. If you want me to do another video and show you more about the panel and around on how to use it, I've set up domains and so on and so forth, let me know in the comment below and I'll make a new video with hopefully I can get 50 likes so I can make the actual video much, much faster. So again, you can change the packages here. You can do a lot more. You can set up your domains. Here you can actually list the actual packages. You can edit, you can create new ones, just like cPanel, Plesk, and so on and so forth. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope to see you next time for a new one.